know we're doing this. Really big, you're really big, right?
He could be out on the golf course right now.
All right, let's go.
Instead, at 73, Rollie Massimino still paces the practice court, coaching the Northwood University Seahawks in West Palm Beach.
I didn't want to play 56 holes of golf every day.
The Seahawks play in front of hundreds, not thousands.
There, shot, right?
This is the Florida Sun Conference, far from the Big East where Massimino once coached, where he once stood on top of the college basketball world.
You just really can't even define it, you know what I mean?
1985, his Villanova Wildcats pulled off one of the greatest upsets of all time, defeating the mighty Georgetown Hoyas 66-64 to win the NCAA title.
It was special. It was special for the players, for the alumni, for the university in itself, and I'm so proud of that.
Mementos of that night are on display in his Tequesta home.
The player's dad made this for us. With the championship ring.
The championship was extra special. He had the chance to coach one of his sons. And that made for interesting conversations at home.
We never argued, my wife and I, but she used to try to not lock the door on me because I'm not playing her son. He needs more playing time, John.
For Roland Massimino, a shoemaker's son, family is more than a word. It's a way of life. He's been with his bride, Mary Jane, for 50 years. They have 5 kids and 17 grandkids. Then, of course, there are the hundreds of players he's coached.
That's all part of me. You know, I enjoy, you know, being around people. I enjoy doing things for people. And, you know, the most important part is that the kids get something out of what they tried to do. Be better than you ever could be.
His extended family bonds would be tested a few years after that perfect moment on the court. Starting point guard Gary McLean admitted he had a drug problem while at school.
All the kids couldn't believe, and you know, there's so many things to this that I was distraught. He's the one that said, you're going to remember us for something that we're going to accomplish.
And after Villanova, there were coaching stops at UNLV and Cleveland State, but no fairy tale endings for Massimino. He would eventually find a winter home in Jupiter Hills. Good friend Paul Anka was one of his sponsors. Life was good. So why would one of the most popular coaches in modern college hoops decide to get back in the game here?
He's nuts, which I tell him a lot of the time. I mean, the guy's 74 years old. He's running around like he's 50.
Chuck Daly, who coached Detroit to the NBA title, is one of Massimino's best friends, hiring him as an assistant when he was coaching at Boston College.
He loves it. He has to do it. It's like in his blood more so than most people.
And coaching at a smaller school doesn't diminish Massimino's responsibilities.
I try to be a mentor. I make sure that they all go to class. You know, that's the number one priority, going to school.
Coach Mass's mentor has proven to be quite successful. When Northwood tipped off its first game in school history in 2006, 8 members of Villanova's championship team were on hand.
That's the most important part of my career. Having the opportunity to be around kids and then have them, I always say, I'm going to give you more than you'll ever give me because I love you and I enjoy you, but let's keep in touch.
While he doesn't do as much recruiting as he once did, I asked Rollie, how much longer can he prowl the sideline?
I like running up and down the court. I enjoy. When that ceases to have me enjoy, you know what I'm doing, that I'm going to start. I don't know, John. I mean, I'm giving you a bunch of rumble jumble. I don't know, quite frankly.